So Dulquer, you had a release last year, Bijoy Nambiar Solo,
yep.
Which was very polarizing. And after that, you wrote this
essay,
emotional essay on Facebook. And, yep. and I want to read this back to you. It's very rare for an actor, I think, to reach out in such a emotional way to his audience. And you said dark comedies are meant to be awkward, always have been. That was our intention. So mocking it, booing it in theatres, spreading negativity and hate and degrading the film because you didn't get it just kills the film. It breaks our hearts, breaks our spirit and kills the courage you gave me all along. Which is such a lovely thing to say. What I mean, where did this come from?
I think, I worked really hard on that film because I...
You were playing four characters.
Yeah, and I genuinely believed in it. But that's okay. I mean, all of us actors work hard on our films and, they work, not work. It's not in our control. But sometimes I feel like because something makes you... In the case of Solo, I feel like it just made them awkward or like it was an uncomfortable scene or revelation. And like a section of the audience then went on to boo it in such a manner or to make it uncomfortable for the other viewers or people who were okay with it or whatever. And then it shouldn't become that it's uncool to go and watch this film. And that's kind of what happened. And now that it's out on social media, they're like raving about it. Or they're like, actually, there's nothing wrong with it. Or what's wrong with the idea? And the thing is, the courage that I've got from the audience is always that if I attempt genuine cinema, that it'll work out. Like, you know, they will appreciate it. And I felt like on the first day, this was being killed and it wasn't being given a chance. And that kind of hurt me, you know. It wasn't so much about the production or, you know, the effort we put into it. It was just, you just didn't give it a fair chance. You know, I don't care if you don't like it, that's fine.
Give it a chance.
Like, I felt like it didn't even get to breathe.
So when something like that happens, Dulquer, does it make you afraid of taking a chance again on a project?
Fortunately, I think what works in our favor is the volume of films we do, you know.
You're doing at least three a year?
3 to 5, yeah.
3 to 5?
Yeah, my dad is 7.
That's so amazing.
So, yeah, amazing. So he's like, you know, Monday finish a film, Tuesday he starts the next one. And I'm like, dude, just take a break, you know, like.
You know, I was watching Ustad Hotel, and there's one scene in which a character looks at you and says, and he's handsome like Mammootty.
So this is something I never got actually growing up. They're like, really? Oh, you don't look anything like your father. So that was the case all the time, right? And so even when they wrote that line in the movie, I was asking the director. I was like, Anurka, should we use that line? Like, I don't quite buy it. I don't think they think that.
I don't
way
think anyone's gonna say it.
And but I mean, now it's, I guess they're okay with it, and I think they find it nice to hear or whatever. I think it's kind of like, it's a very Indian thing to kind of see.
But it's just sweet.
It's sweet, yeah.
You
it's
know, just it just makes me smile. Yourself,
yeah, exactly. Right? But I always thought like, no way. Like, and this is another reason that I didn't know if I could make it as an actor, because I was like, I don't look anything as good as my father, or I don't know if I can perform like him. He's very obviously manly and obviously, baritone, and there's just no one like him.
He's a man's man.
Man's man.
Yeah.
And I'm more like boyish or whatever it is.
Right.
So I remember kind of cringing when I read that line for the first time. Even when watching it, I'm like face palm. But it's sweet. So, I mean, like it comes from a good place.
Is there a burden, Dulquer, to being his son?
I think less now. So now when you talk about me, I feel, you say Ustad Hotel, or you say Bangalore Days, or Charlie, you don't immediately say Mr. Mammootty's son. So, but the burden, I think, growing up was that, like, I just didn't want to fail in anything I do. You know, it's just, not just about being an actor, I just thought, he's always led by example, he's got great integrity, and lives by his principles, and so many ways. I just wanted to make sure, like, I make him proud, you know, and that's kind of the thing with our entire family. Like, nobody rose to heights like he did, so even within
you mean the larger family?
Larger family. It's like something everybody really looks up to, you know. So I just had to kind of live up to that, you know. So so I think that's helped me in always trying to do quality cinema, always trying to kind of perform as well as I can, and choosing for the right reasons, just generally my conduct and behavior, things like that.
But that's pressure you put on yourself. He's
true,
never put
true
on you.
Yeah, no, I think he's always just told me.
Was he a tough dad?
No, he was a very cool dad in that sense. He said, look, I'm not going to ask you to be the first in class. I'm not going to ask you to study hard or whatever. But I'm the best at what I'm doing. 3 national awards.
No pressure, yeah. But I'm the best.
I'm the best. So whatever I do, I'm the best. So whatever you do, make sure you are the best at it. But I'm not going to tell you to do it. I'm just showing you what how it's done. Brrrr.